Hey everyone, it's Rydor the Banisher here, aka at Rymok1, and in this video I will be showcasing all of the changes made to the Infinite Archive in Update 43 for the Elder Scrolls Online. I'll show you all the new stuff that was added, as well as the new class sets, the undead avatar, the new verses and visions, etc. So, let's get it. Okay, so the first big change with the Infinite Archive in Update 43 is the addition of a new daily quest. The quest giver is called Esalinwi, located in between Master Melkest and the merchant Filer Ol. The daily quest will task you with either killing a marauder or 10 fabled, etc. Basically, tasks that you're going to do anyway if you're going to do an Infinite Archive run, at least into Arc 2. Doing this daily quest rewards you with the typical archival fortunes and gold, and more importantly, the newest item added with Update 43, the Mystery Transformation Verse. This is a consumable verse just like any other one, except it lets you transform into one of the four avatars without needing to have collected their three verses. So this is a game changer. If you have been struggling to get the Inkslayer achievement or to defeat the Arc 4 Thoat, this will definitely help you do that. Okay, so next I'm going to show you the new undead avatar and how you can get it. So there are three visions that you can obtain in a run, just like the other avatars: Necrotic Fortification, Necrotic Support, and Necrotic Strikes. Once you have all three visions, then the undead avatar verse has a chance to drop. So the undead avatar is really, really good, and it's right up there with the werewolf behemoth avatar. So what it does, every 30 seconds, your slain enemies increase your damage by 5% when you use your graveyard synergy. And the avatar also reduces damage taken by 30%, as well as an additional increase to your damage done by 30%, and it makes you immune to crowd control. But again, with the addition of the new daily quest and the Mystery Transformation Verse, you don't need to worry about collecting all three visions for an avatar anymore. Just do your daily quest every day and save up some Mystery Verses, and then you can go full-on avatar mode with every Thoat fight during a run. Alright, next up let's show the new class sets added with Update 43. For the Arcanist, we have Spattering Disjunction set. Crit, weapon spell damage, 5-piece. Dealing damage with an Arcanist ability applies 2 random status effects to the target every 7 seconds. Damage dealt with a Herald of the Tomb ability reduces this cooldown by half a second up to 1 second. Okay, next up for the Dragon Knight, we have the Pyrebrand set. Penetration, weapon spell damage, 5 pieces. Your light attacks deal X flame damage over 6 seconds. Or a fully charged heavy attack consumes 3 of your damage over time effects, dealing X flame damage for 6 seconds. Enemies that are under 33% health take 200% more damage. Okay, next for Necromancers, we have the Corpse Buster set. Weapon spell damage, crit, 5 pieces. Consuming a corpse causes it to explode, dealing X magicka damage. Increases damage by 10% per Gravelord ability slotted. Enemies damaged by the explosion get Major Breach for 5 seconds. I mean, wow, this set is good. Okay, next up for Nightblades, we have the Umbral Edge set. Max health, armor, max stam, the 5-piece. When you cast a shadow ability, gain Umbral Riposte for 3 seconds, dodging the next attack, and applying Major Vulnerability to your enemy for 5 seconds, increasing their damage taken by 10%. Next up we have Sorcerer, Beacon of Oblivion class set. Armor, weapon and spell damage, max health. 5th piece bonus. With a pet active, increase your health and armor by X. With no pet is active, increase damage and healing done by 15%. Next we have Templar and the Etheric Lancer set. Weapon and spell damage, crit, weapon and spell damage, 5-piece. Dealing damage with Burning Light twice within 30 seconds creates an area around you. While within the area, dealing damage with an Aedric Spear ability launches spears at your opponent, dealing X magicka damage and increasing your damage by 300 for 6 seconds. Lastly, we have Warden and the Ares Cry set. Penetration, weapon and spell damage, weapon and spell damage, fifth piece. Light attacks apply Eagle's Mark to your opponent for 12 seconds. Every 3 seconds, an Eagle attacks, dealing X physical damage. Eagle's Mark also applies Ares Call to the caster for 12 seconds, increasing your damage done with Animal Companion abilities by 10%. Okay, some other things that have been added to the Infinite Archive with Update 43. The Merchant Filer to Xur's now sells style pages for all classes. And he also sells the Scribing Altar that you can put into your house for 30,000 archival fortunes. Filer Brax is right next to Filer to Xur's, and this merchant sells set pieces for 10,000 archival fortunes apiece, including the new class sets. So if you have a ton of archival fortunes to burn, this is a good way to help you finish off that sticker book. As a side note, you can also purchase the Scribing Altar for your house from Faustina, the Achievement Mediator. She stands next to Rollis Hallu, and they are found in the zones of Stormhaven, Deshaun, and Grotwood. Faustina sells the altar for 800 writ vouchers, but you can also buy the altar for gold from guild traders, so it really just depends on what you have more currency of. There is also a new jewelry station furnishing of the Apocrypha style that came out with Update 43, and all of the leads for this station drop from the Infinite Archive. These leads drop from the end of throwout fights, marauders, and boss fights. Update 43 also added 2 new marauders to the Infinite Archive for you to encounter. First we have Bittog, which is basically Balrog's little brother. Bittog has similar mechanics to the Balrog fight in the March of Sacrifices. Bittog will howl and turn the arena to shadow, but in this instance you do not have to run and find the light. It's more of just an inconvenience to not be able to see pesky adds like Fabled. Next, Bittog will wind up a big heavy attack, and it does hit twice, so you want to make sure you block or dodge roll it. After that, Bittog will do a choreographed charge. It's easy enough to avoid. So overall, Bittog is a bit of a pushover, and he's easy enough to defeat. The second marauder added in Update 43 is Zul Fimbul, and he behaves much like the Minotaur boss in the Vatishiran Hollows arena. If you run away from him, he will jump and slam you. And next, his heavy attack is literally no joke. You might want to block it. Otherwise, you might get a screen that looks like this, like the one I did in Arc 4. Yeah, that's a 36k unblocked heavy attack. But overall, Zul Fimbul, he's not too much to handle. He will put a lot of AoE down on the ground. So as you're moving out of it, just make sure to keep looking for that heavy attack. He winds it up pretty good. It's easy to telegraph. Just make sure that you block it or dodge roll it, and you should be just fine. Update 43 also added new verses that you can obtain after every stage, and many of them are quite powerful. There are also new arenas slash stages that have environmental damage like fire and ice, so be mindful of these as well. There are also many new visions that you can obtain after every boss fight, including the new undead avatar visions. Update 43 also added new boss fights for the Infinite Archive, including Sail Ripper from the Dreadsail Wreath Trial, Coven Geryon from the Balsunar Dungeon, and Draenos from the Cradle of Shadows Dungeon, just to name a few. Overall, I must say that the additions to the Infinite Archive for Update 43 are quite amazing. This is the kind of endgame content updates that I love to see, and if Zoss continues to add to the Infinite Archive and possibly adopt this format for other arenas, etc., it could be very refreshing as a player. So with that, I thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned something useful about the Infinite Archive and the new additions from Update 43. So thank you again. This is Rydor. Out. Every time I get the undead avatar, I just feel like Gru with all his minions, and I want them all to yell, BANANA!